We're joined now by the Harford County Executive, Barry Glassman. Always good to have you on. Appreciate you coming on the show. You heard in that soundbite that Governor Hogan was talking about everybody is looking for the PPE especially. I am curious, how does it work for the counties? Are you looking for it on your own as well, or are you leaving it up to the state to find it and then have the state dole it out?
No, my emergency preparedness folks, we're out there purchasing also. I've got a transfer before the county council this week for some additional funding. We're working on getting masks and some PPE. We're in pretty good shape here in Harford County. Our numbers have been pretty steady. I mean, they're going up, but right now we're holding our own. But as this proceeds, I think even, you know, over the summer, our folks are still going to need PPEs and masks to handle EMS calls going forward, because, you know, the virus is going to be with us to some degree for a while until we get a vaccine. And so that kind of equipment is going to be needed, you know, for the next 6 months or so.
All right. So this obviously has had a massive economic impact. I know your budget is coming out. Is that reflected in your budget, or see these some of kind of the older numbers?
Well, it's sort of some of the older numbers, but I started looking at it in early March and really cut back on capital spending. That's spending that we use cash or pay-as-you-go funds. So I am going to push back and delay several projects just to keep our reserves up. We've been fortunate in Harford County. I've got about a $22 million fund balance in addition to our rainy day fund. So we've done a pretty good job kind of putting away and saving up for these kind of circumstances so we can weather it. I would really preface that by saying we can weather this for one or two quarters, mm-hmm. but I think if you looked at the comptroller's numbers on Friday at his press conference, to some degree, we've got to begin this balancing act of opening up and maintaining public health. But I don't see how Maryland counties and the state can go beyond 3 or 4 months of this at the max.
Well, do you have a projection of how, you know, big the budget shortfall will be?
Well, we know, and we don't really have a shortfall yet, but next year we're
projection,
looking at
a projection, right? Because you got to have, I would assume that the tax revenue is going to plummet.
Exactly. Normally we look for Maryland counties, particularly Harford, we look for about a 3% growth. So we've already cut that in half, and it's likely to be flat by the time you project this out. So for Harford County, it could be a $17 to $20 million shortfall. Now, this is all kind of based on how long this goes on, whether it's 1 month. If we begin to open back in May, those numbers look better. But if you look at a full 3 or 4 month slowdown, that's the kind of figures that we're looking at alone in Harford County.
All right. We're talking with Barry Glassman, County Executive in Harford County, Republican. There is a movement now in other areas across the country, and even here in the state of Maryland now, Montgomery County and Prince George's County are doing this to say you have to wear masks when out in the public, especially when shopping at either the grocery store, pharmacy, or big box stores. Do you see a policy like that happening in Harford County?
Well, Bryan, what I've been trying to do is follow the CDC recommendations from the federal to the state level and with Governor Hogan's team. So if the CDC, you know, recommends that we do that, we certainly follow suit. But right now it's a recommendation. So I think we're trying to stay uniform and do what the federal government and the state government want to unilaterally sign some kind of requirement.
Okay, so you broke up there for a second. So you're basically waiting to hear from the federal government or from the state level that's the only way it would happen in Harford County, it sounds like?
We're trying to follow the recommendations from the CDC to the state health department. And if they certainly say that it should be mandated, we'd follow suit. But right now, it's a recommendation, and we're trying to encourage folks to do it, but I don't foresee signing some kind of executive order until The state tells us that that's what they want us to do.
All right. There's obviously a lot of talk about the schools and the future of schools, not only for this year, but down the road, and needing to have the technology to do this e-learning. Does that mean then that the school systems actually are going to need more money? And how are you going to be able to work that with, as you said, maybe $17 to $20 million of money that you just don't have right now?
Yeah, that's the difficult part. And I think in our funding proposal that we'll send to the board later today, we'll be some additional funding in there for technology. But, you know, I'd point out that in a lot of spots in Maryland, folks really don't have broadband yet or reliable Wi-Fi to the extent that children could get connected to learn. So I think we've been pushing and with the congressional delegation and through the state that if they do an infrastructure or some kind of investment, there are still many underserved areas of the state where you can have a nice Chromebook and all the technology you want, but unless families, number one, can afford it or connect to it, that I think it's a little bit of a red herring to say we can do e-learning in Maryland, because there are just frankly a lot of families that are not connected to the extent that they can do it.
Yeah, I'll let you go on that question too, which is Kerwin, which is, you know, a lot of, and you've been saying for quite some time, maybe we just need to test it out first, because, you know, the affordability, this was before the pandemic. Do you think Kerwin is at least on pause, if not dead?
Well, you know, the legislature rushed through a bill in the final week or so. And so there is a bill sitting out there. And I think the governor, quite frankly, on his last press conference, I think is going to veto most bills that have a fiscal note. And Bryan, you know, I've been saying this, even in a good economic environment, a $4 billion investment was a stretch for Maryland, even in the best of times. So I think it's clear that that bill shouldn't move forward. Now, some folks say they did put a circuit breaker in there, but I can tell you that circuit breaker can't be flipped on and off when we're looking at, I think, a long-term recovery here. Even after 3 or 4 months, it's going to take a state and the counties a year to get back on their feet. And there is no circuit breaker in that bill for Maryland counties that have to come up with the additional funds. So, that one I think needs to be put off, and maybe they can work on a delayed effective date, but certainly shouldn't start new spending right now.
All right, very good. Mr. County Executive, always a pleasure to have you on. Appreciate your time.
Yep, you guys be safe.
Me too. Republican County Executive, Harford County, Barry Glassman.